y'all, JM back here in the shop after shooting this Kimber stainless TLE II. So let's go ahead and field strip it and clean it. Now if you've not ever field stripped a 1911 or especially a Kimber like this TLE II, you'll find out that it's a little bit different to do so. So we'll take this step by step and show you some of the differences in field stripping a gun like this than in something as simple like the Glock or the SIG. Okay, so the first thing as always, we're going to get the magazine out. We're going to make sure that we're clear, and we are. Everything's ready to break down. So in order to take this down and field strip it, we're going to take the barrel as well as the recoil spring out the front of the gun. Now some of the Kimber, especially the compact models, you go ahead and rack the slide back, and there's a little pinhole right here that you put a little paperclip type device in. It holds the spring intact as you take down the slide. But this TLE II does not have this little hole, so it takes down just a little bit differently. So what we're going to need to do to take the barrel and the recoil spring out is push the recoil spring plug, which is under a lot of tension, back just enough so that we can turn the barrel bushing clockwise, unlock the plug recoil spring, and allow it to come forward. Now you've got to be careful with this because the recoil spring is under a lot of pressure and it'll shoot this plug out like a bullet, hit you between the eyes or knock out the lights or whatever, so you've got to be very cautious when you do that. Now some people might use their thumb, push down, and then try to turn this, but I'm going to use the Kimber tool to do that. And this Kimber tool has a little notch on it that actually allows you to push the plug down as you turn the barrel bushing to the side. Now as you do that, you're going to release the recoil spring and plug, so make sure you've got your hand over it to control that release, or it's going to end up in your ceiling. So let's see how we do that. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. We'll put our little device on so that we've got the notch over the recoil spring plug and push down. So we're going to push down and then come clockwise. I'm going to get my hand over that plug so I'll make sure and control it. I come clockwise and I've got complete control of this recoil spring plug and the recoil spring. So now we go ahead and take out a recoil spring and the recoil spring plug. So the next thing we're going to do is take out the takedown lever. So to get this out, we're going to line up the notch right here with this little node on the takedown lever. As soon as we get it lined up, then on the opposite side, we're going to push this little pin out and it'll just slide right out. Okay, you've got to get this lined up exactly right, then push it on the opposite side and it slides out. So to this point, we've taken out a recoil spring with a recoil spring plug by turning the barrel bushing clockwise, and now we've got out our takedown lever. So let's go ahead and get our slide off, and the slide simply comes right off. Okay, so now we're ready to get our recoil spring rod out as well as the barrel out, so we'll push those back. And as you notice, this little lever right here on the back of the barrel, this is what we're going to line this hole back up with our takedown pin when we're putting this back together. So right now, let's go ahead, we'll push this back up so that we can get our recoil spring rod out, and now we're ready to get the barrel out. So the barrel is going to come out the front of the gun, and to do that, we now spin the barrel bushing around counterclockwise until we line up this little notch on the barrel bushing so it will come out. That little notch locks the barrel bushing in place, so you can see this little notch now. And when we put it back in and turn it back clockwise, it locks the barrel bushing. Barrel bushing's got to come off to get the barrel out. So we line the notch up, take out the barrel bushing. Now we push the little lever forward on the back of the barrel, and the barrel should slide right out. Now we've got our components and ready to clean. Okay, so let's get some ballast oil in the barrel. Let it be penetrating. Same thing with the recoil spring. Okay, let's go ahead and brush down our frame, get it wiped down a little bit. I'm going to use a dry brush back here at the firing pin. Do not get oil or lubricant back there. It'll just gum up. Okay, let's go ahead and wipe down the recoil spring rod. Take down lever. Slide release. Recoil spring plug and the barrel bushing. clean off our magazine a little bit. Make sure recoil spring is cleaned off a little bit. Get some of this gunk off the back of the barrel. Okay, patches are looking pretty good. Not bad. So let's go ahead and reassemble it. Well, as you might think, reassembling is just a little bit different too. So the first thing we're going to do is get our barrel and our recoil spring rod back in. So next we're going to put the slide back on the frame, and this is where we're going to end up lining up this little lever, this hole here, with a hole in the frame so that we get our pin back in correctly. So we take our slide, put it on the frame, slide it back in place, and then we're going to line these holes up so that we can get our lever back in correctly. Okay, we now have the hole in the frame and the little hole in the hinge device on the back of the barrel lined up so that our takedown pin or slide release will go right in there. So it's now going through the frame into that little hole on the back of the barrel. Now we line this notch up once again back here to this opening so that we can put our takedown pin back the way it started. Okay, we now have this little notch back where it's supposed to be so that this node can go right in. Sometimes you have to kind of work this little takedown pin back in place, so you get it underneath there a little bit and just pop it right in. So now we've got our takedown pin back together. Okay, now we're ready to go ahead and get our barrel locked into place. So we're going to get our barrel bushing. Remember the little notch? We're going to get that little notch lined back up so that it'll slide into place. See, the little notch goes right in. And then we can turn our barrel bushing and it's locked in place. Barrel bushing is now turned clockwise so that when we get the recoil spring and the recoil plug down, then the barrel bushing is going to slide over and lock this mechanism in place. So securing the recoil spring can be one of the hardest parts to do. You just need to be careful so that you don't end up getting this little recoil spring plug again nailed between your eyes. So the recoil spring is going to slide back on the recoil spring rod. Okay, some people push this down with their thumb and then lock it back into place with a barrel bushing. What I'm going to do is actually hold it in place with this little device from Kimber. That doesn't wear my thumb out quite as bad. So we'll get it down there. And we're ready now to turn. Okay, we've got it. We'll just turn this around and we'll lock it into place. Okay, we fill stripped, clean, reassembled, get the magazine back in, and we're ready to go shoot again. Hey, thanks y'all for viewing us here at Real Guys Reviews. We appreciate it. Hope to see you around.